The New South Wales government has prioritised reform with a timeframe that recognises the critical importance of ensuring that students develop the fundamental basics in English and mathematics in the very first years at school. Curriculum reforms to cater to English and mathematics syllabuses are key to building strong foundations in the early years. What was in the first draft of the K-2 English and mathematics outcomes and content? New outcomes clearly show what is essential. Content organised and sequenced to highlight the connections across concepts underpinning the latest research. Identified essential foundation knowledge and skills. From the 23rd of March until the 30th of April, we consulted on the English and Mathematics K-2 draft outcomes and content. Over the six-week Have Your Say period, we had a high level of interest, which included 743 responses to the online survey and conducted a range of focus groups with our key stakeholders. Focus groups included representation from diversity, Aboriginal education, parent associations, sector representatives, and key stakeholder groups. The groups provided specific feedback relating to their expertise. The responses to the online survey showed that over 85% of respondents in both English and mathematics either agreed or strongly agreed that the outcomes are explicit and clear statements of the essential knowledge and skills. Over 85% of respondents found the sample teaching advice developed to support syllabus outcomes helpful. Respondents agreed that outcomes and content have a firm evidence base. Respondents overwhelmingly supported the structure of both English and mathematics. The focus groups and the survey provided constructive feedback, which has been incorporated into this second draft.
Stakeholders were pleased to see the explicit nature of the content and outcomes. However, they suggested there were opportunities to include content for students with complex disability. For this second draft, sample access points have been provided for. Early Stage 1, representing whole numbers. And Early Stage 1, combining and separating quantities. Feedback during this consultation period will inform the further development of access points for the remaining outcomes, and these will be included in the final syllabus. Teaching advice includes additional support for teachers in the implementation of these outcomes for students with complex needs. Respondents supported the increased focus on mathematical reasoning in the early years. Stakeholders requested support materials to help teachers develop students' reasoning skills. A reasoning in number example has been included in the second draft to assist teachers to identify opportunities for student reasoning. We are also creating support material to help teachers identify and develop reasoning in the early years. Some respondents suggested there were further opportunities for money to be included in the examples in the syllabus. Coins and notes have been introduced as a context for counting and grouping in the number and algebra strand. Decimal currency as a system will be introduced in Stage 2, along with decimal notation. Some experts suggested that there was an opportunity for more emphasis on place value in Stage 1. We have addressed this with the inclusion of an explicit place value outcome in Stage 1, number and algebra. Respondents appreciated the inclusion of technical language for both students and teachers, but indicated support materials would be useful to develop a shared understanding. Teaching advice now includes examples of student language and key vocabulary demands related to the outcome. The new syllabuses have a streamlined structure which include an aim and rationale, outcomes, and content. The rationale assists teachers and students to develop a common understanding about the value and importance of mathematics. The aim provides a statement of the purpose in relation to mathematics and the educational benefits for students. The mathematics outcomes and content will be tagged to version 3 of the National Numeracy Learning Progression when the final syllabus is released. Respondents agreed that the inclusion of teaching advice linked to syllabus outcomes will be very helpful. Teaching advice has been further developed to include advice for supporting the diversity of learners. The examples in the syllabus have also been revised to ensure they represent diverse learners. Some elements from previous syllabuses are now located in the support materials.
The drafts of the English and Mathematics Cater 2 syllabuses will be available for review and feedback. Once this second Have Your Say period has ended, NESA will use the feedback to progress to the final version of the syllabuses. The final Cater 2 syllabuses will be available to schools on a new digital platform by 2022. By Term 1 2023, the new syllabuses will be fully implemented in schools.